So this is going to be a video about Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company and the founder, Frank Seiberling, and his estate in Akron, Ohio. They didn't want video in the house, but I did get a little video. We took a tour to where we were able to go into parts where the public wasn't able to go, like in the boiler room and in the attic. And we saw the fuel room, the phone switchboards. There's a big pool, indoor pool that can be set at three different levels. It was just an interesting place. The gardens there were amazing. So if you're in the Akron area, well worth a visit. So this is a video on the family that owned Goodyear Tire and Rubber. Enjoy and thank you for watching.
There are few greater blessings than to be able to appreciate your ancestors. And it's hard to live up to. I could not even try, but I love what they did and I love telling their story and I'm so grateful that it's able to be told. But it is also the story of millions of Americans who may not have a lovely estate or landscaped estate to show for it. Millions of Americans have
all right, his daytime. Or his blog. Pioneered into a wilderness. Yeah, this is nice. I would totally live here.
Sort of has that,
the breakfast room garden. Oh, this is where they hung the laundry. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And they put those in before they hit the wall. But we've got them in there now. And then we use this area for a lot of storage back here. And so we'll go back up this way. And the kind of rooflet you see on an angle here, mm-hmm. That's the top of the decoration. That is the great.
It was built in the 1880s, so it's
where it falls.
And then, you know, they'll get up there. In their money, basically it was
rolls for the player organ.
Translated into our money is about 22 mil, but translated into
pipes are there and there.
This chair they just put out this year. They found it again and got it.
That's the orchestra pit, so to speak. It's like a piano with a harp. No water in the fountain.
There's your word elevator.
Yeah. Fuel elevator is what they called it.
A what?
Fuel elevator. Yeah, to have carved wooden doors of that leading into this. Even. That was held with the chain in the attic. Window right there that goes into something. It's a dining room.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We got
like, just this first floor to that pantry room and
In the kitchen. Anyone like an egg? Those pots and pans are original to the house, as is the stove, which is a tri-fuel. We're on wood, coal, or natural gas.
Just look at how bright this breakfast room, you know, is.
Yeah.
I'd be happy it's just this for, you know, a roof dining room.
All the flower arrangements in here from the gardens here.
Office. Cigars, smoking room.
This is the boys' wing.
But that's one of the children.
Yeah,
right?
That's definitely.
Right.
Right. This one. This one.
Must be nice. Oh, that's probably where his friend would sleep. Yeah.
That was a sleeping porch.
Sleeping porch. Yeah.
Oh, on a hot day.
Yeah.
Actually, a pretty nice shower in here for this air. Bathroom was through that door. Say 98% of the stuff in the house was their stuff. Beds are much tinier in that area. I guess people weren't as huge like they are now. But another interesting thing is the doors had vents in them so you could get airflow through them, and there's the living room and pretty nice. This is the girls' wing. Cleaning closet. That was where we just came from.
smell really good.
Thank you.
That is not period correct. But this would be his room. Period correct then was the men and the women slept in separate bedrooms. Well, there's that window I was pointing from the living room. So that overlooks that room where the chandelier and everything is. All closet.
Also, this is how this is said the temperature is about. This is
good. I can't get close to that, but you might be able to read it. Some air. Bathroom stalls, yeah, more storage. Go. Back of the pipe organ room.
Actually, I don't remember ever walking the gardens on this side of the.
So this is the English, English garden. Yeah, it looks like a torture treatment more than more than a fountain.
They're being cooled off by a naked woman.
Like a nice patio area. Leads down to the pond, which has lily pads with flowers. And there's a dragonfly on that one right there. bees and the other flowers. Those pads, aren't they cool? Hillside is ivy.
Yeah. That's a mistake. They should have never planted it back there.
Yeah, I don't know if
they
did.
Well, when it gets large, it's going
to... They're going to have to take it out.
Yeah.
That was a Japanese garden. Wow, nice. And down on the other side of that wall was the garden where they used to hang the laundry out to dry, which is now like a patio, which was in the earlier part of the video. Nice long, this goes to the greenhouses. The driveway where the cars would come in to unload stuff. Bowling lawn. The gardens go the full length of this walking path. Really amazing. There's a scarecrow over there. I don't know if it shows up in the video or not. Right, kind of right in there. And the greenhouses are down through there. We'll walk down here and see what's down here. And that's the end of the bowling lawn. I don't think they had those in the back in the day. Pretty big garden here. This is inside the greenhouse. The gate is right there. that enters the property toward the house that we went through. These are the flower gardens. They're having a light, 3D light show here, so that's why these tacky lights are throughout the gardens. And I'm not going to go into great detail on them. There are a lot of flowers that you can find in your typical backyard garden. Well, their cannas are quite nice. Little leaf pattern on there. So if you watch my videos, you know I like the garden, so this is kind of up my alley. My mom was an avid green thumb, and my dad constantly tells me I take after her. Well, that looks like about it for the estate here. So if you enjoy my channel, please subscribe. And thank you very much for watching.